Welcome to VO Inside Business. I'm Christian Schlereth and I'm here at the BCG headquarters, and I'm together with Carsten Kratz, head of Boston Consulting Group Germany. Carsten, I appreciate that you're taking your time.
It's a pleasure.
Talking about big data, when do you consider data to be big, and what is possible today that was unthinkable, let's say, a decade ago?
Well, I mean, if you look at the last decade, I mean, we have seen a huge explosion in processing power from computers. We have seen a huge increase of available network bandwidth. We have seen a huge increase of available storage. What I'd argue has changed over the last 2 years is the fact that we have made significant progress on image recognition and on voice speech recognition. So due to this availability of data, of significantly more data, I'd argue that we see a completely new level in terms of opportunities on a advanced analytics, or some may even call it artificial intelligence level. And indeed, this is changing, is transforming the way we work. Also, we at BCG. If you look at a typical case team in today's world with 5, 6, 7 consultants, on basically all of those cases, you will find 2 or 3 advanced analytics / artificial intelligence specialists supporting those teams in their day-to-day work.
Yeah. But does that also mean that algorithms will eventually substitute human-made managerial decision-making?
To take a very simple example, think of maintenance. Yeah, all of those machines ever since need to have a kind of go through maintenance program. In past or in today's world, to a large extent, this is process-based. So you have a manual, as you have in your car, which basically says every second day you do this, and once a week you do that, and every second month you do that. In the near future, and in some plants today, with artificial intelligence, you have so many sensors that basically your machine at any time, real time, tells you, look, if you don't do this thing, this activity, with a probability of 2% within the next 4 hours, you will have a system down on that step. So this is a completely new way how you interface between human machine. Due to the fact that we have all of these opportunities on the artificial intelligence side, we will change the way we define the interface between humans and machines, but we will have humans around also in future.
Companies such as Facebook and Amazon or Google, they successfully demonstrated the use of advanced analytics for their company success. Can you describe what advanced analytics is, and especially how German companies can capitalize from their data knowledge?
So I'd argue that the use cases you see in B2C are different than those you see in B2B. Specifically, if you think of B2C, you will see a lot of customer targeting. In B2B, obviously, it's more about optimizing supply chains. You know the patterns of your clients, and you adapt your manufacturing volumes, your slots, etc. So that being said, I'd argue that specifically the German industry is in an extremely good starting position. We do have in Germany the most modern machines installed in our factories. I'd argue we have the best skilled employees out there, and this obviously provides a foundation to take this to the new level, to move into what we call Industry 4.0.
But what about the role of owning the data? I mean, German companies, they are experts in vertical integration. They are very well connected within their supply chain, but not necessarily, they do not have a close contact with the customers. Doesn't that pose a problem?
Obviously, innovation has what I would call an incremental and then a disruptive element in it. So the challenge is to get the balance right. If you think about the German automotive industry, which I think is a benchmark industry for many decades, obviously they need to think through what new mobility concepts, car sharing platforms, etc., what does it mean for their business? So this is the disruptive part, but at the same time, they need to have attractive SUVs, cabrios, whatever, next year, diesel engines. So it's about both. It's not kind of we are a startup, we have a very successful legacy, so we need to take incrementally the legacy to the next level in terms of innovation, and still we need to be open for more kind of disruptive things.
Carsten, thank you very much for spending time with us.
It's been a pleasure, and good luck with your interesting initiative.
Thank you.